Over 800 bodies remain unclaimed in Odisha following India's deadliest rail crash in two decades. Authorities now appealing to families to claim the bodies of their loved ones. Officials say autopsies cannot be performed unless the families identify the bodies. In the meantime, authorities are currently trying to source ice containers to preserve the unidentified remains. A collision involving three trains killed more than 270 people in Odisha on Sunday.
Ukraine and Russia trade blame over the breach of a major Soviet-era dam in southern Ukraine. Heavy damage caused water to burst through the Russian-controlled Novokakhovka Dam, or Kakhovka Dam, on Tuesday. The dam supplies water to the Crimean Peninsula and a nuclear power plant that had been annexed by Moscow. Russian state media reported over 300 households in the town of Novokakhovka have been evacuated. Around 22,000 more people in surrounding settlements are at risk of flooding. One Russian official says it would be impossible to repair the dam. The National Bureau of Investigation set to recommend charges against 35 individuals in connection with the massive oil spill in Mindoro. Our correspondent Nico Bawa now on the line for more. Nico?
Ron, the National Bureau of Investigation Environmental Crimes Division have already recommended the filing of charges in the DOJ against 35 individuals in connection to their investigation of the sinking of MP Princess Empress, which resulted in the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro last February. They have recommended the filing of the charges of perjury and falsification of public documents against the owners of MP Princess Empress, which is RDC Rail Services, who is owned by the Cabyal family. They recommended the filing of perjury and falsification of public documents because of allegedly the family or the company allegedly falsely claimed that the ship was newly built in Bataan, when in the investigation the NBI discovered that the ship was allegedly made of or was rather a refurbished ship which was made in a illegal shipyard in Navota. Besides that, according to the affidavit submitted to the DOJ, there were contradictions in the process of how the ship was built in Navota. They also discovered some documents which were allegedly falsified for them to obtain a certificate of Philippine registry and a certificate of public convenience. The NBI also recommended the charges of falsification or use of falsified documents against the marina. The marina was in charge for regulating or overseeing how the ship MP Princess Empress was built. However, the regional director of the marina was able to issue the certificate for the ship, which allegedly claimed that it was built again in Bataan, and in Bataan, when in fact it was built in Navota. So the DOJ is saying that there was an irregularity on Marina's end in making sure that the ship was built according to the process of their submission of documents in obtaining the certificate. The NBI also recommended the filing of use of falsified documents against the officials of the Philippine Coast Guard, because prior to the ship sinking, the ship was able to set sail for at least 18 times using a falsified certificate of public convenience. A certificate of public convenience is needed for a ship for it to be able to set sail. However, upon investigation, it showed that the CPC that was being used by the MP Princess Empress was not authentic. And DOJ was earlier explaining that the Philippine Coast Guard should have been able to verify the CPC first before allowing the ship to set sail. So that's why they were also being recommended to be charged for that complaint. The ship's captain and crew were also charged or recommended to be filed with the case of use of falsified documents because of the CPC that was used during those voyages. The NBI is set to file another batch of cases for another set of respondents in the coming weeks for the environmental offenses that were allegedly made by those responsible in the oil spill. And they're also looking at other cases such as graft and corruption, which they may file in the future. Ron?
Nico Bao with that story. Thank you very much, Nico.